President of IMA Chidambaram, Dr. R. Bhaskaran, also Professor and HOD of Pediatric, Chairman IMA Academic Activities, Dr. S. Ramesh, and equally important, our professors Vasupalya and also Dr. Ratna. All the respected distinguished guests. So once again, good morning. Yesterday morning, when I arrived in Bombay, I come all the way from Ethiopia. So I'm very happy. Eventually, I arrived in India, but the custom refused my entry to India because I forgotten to bring this yellow fever this certificate. Okay. So then he asked me, I talked for I think more than 5 minutes, no? He still refused, no, you cannot enter India, or you stay here for 10 days, this is thing. Then he asked me, what are you doing here, sir? I say, I'm going to, what do you call, Annamalai Medical College. I have very important meeting. We have been treating this, what do you call, children of malnutrition, okay? So we have a very important conference. So immediately after listening to me, then he said, okay, sir, next time you bring this thing, quietly he let me go. So I think this medical college must be very famous. Just one mention, I enter India. So we talk about global health. Okay, many people thought that malnutrition is only like developing country, India, and also in Ethiopia. Ethiopia also about 40% malnutrition. That's not true. Even in advanced country like Australia, Europe, America, also suffering from malnutrition. Okay, now let me explain. One day, when I remember many years ago, okay, I went to Australia to give my first lecture in Australia. So there are many doctors coming, okay, this thing. So before I start my lecture, no, one of the doctors told me, Dr. Lim, today you better don't talk about granuloma. Okay, then I asked him why. They wanted to know acupuncture, because we are very familiar with acupuncture. They want to know acupressure. Don't talk about granuloma. I asked him why. Because we do not need mushroom. We do not need spirulina. He told me, I asked him why. He said, look, Dr. Lim, in Australia, we have very clean food, you know, organic food. We take organic food, we clean food. And our water is very clean. Okay, you open the taps, you can drink the water. The water is very clean. The air is also very clean. In Australia, you look at the sky, it's very blue, you know, very clean. This thing. So we have clean food, we have clean water, we have clean air. We do not need this food supplement, this thing. Then I'm thinking, what to explain to them? Then I ask them one question, you know. In Asia Pacific, I mean Malaysia, Hong Kong, China, Australia, New Zealand, which country have the highest suicide rate? People commit suicide. Which country have the highest mental breakdown? It is Australia. Then I ask Australian, now you have clean food, you have clean water, you have clean air, clean government, everything clean. Why should you commit suicide? And why should you become cracko, no? This is the thing. Then they asked me why. Then I told them, you are suffering from malnutrition. Then they say, Dr. Lim, you must be mistaken, you know. This is Australia, this is not Africa. Okay. I told them, many people associate malnutrition with insufficient of food. Okay. Now you look at India. India, we are not lacking of food. This is the thing. Government also subsidize rice, everything. So you go to Australia, people eating so much, they become so fast, obesity become a problem. So how can we say the amount malnutrition? The problem is that now the food are mechanized. We already produce food in a huge quantity. The food of human being have become monotonous. We eat only same type of food every day, you know. So I asked Australia, what do you take in the morning? So you take cornflakes, you take milk. What do you take in the afternoon? Okay, maybe some fried chicken, some this thing. Every day you eat the same type of food. If every day you eat the same type of food, what will happen to you? You look at Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea, the island on top of this thing, there's one tribal people. They eat only badana. They eat only one type of banana, this thing. Are they survive? Yes, they survive. But their life expectancy is less than 40 years old. Very few of them live more than 40 years old, this thing. Our body can produce whatever nutrient we want. Okay, we. But the problem is that when you restrict your food, you exert, no? You exert a lot of stress on the body, and then the life expectancy become very low. Recently, I went to South Sudan. Okay, South Sudan, many people died at the age of 50. Very few of them, even the Prime Minister of Ethiopia, died at the age of 52. Why? Because when they are small, okay, you see, when a child is small, it's malnutrition. So when they grow out, even though they eat a lot of things, it look physically very strong, you know, died very young. Because the body already stressed in the early day of the this thing. That's why nutrient is very important in a sense that we need to diversify the this thing. As a human being, if you keep eating the same type of food every day, that is sure a formula for disease, and also you will die very young. This thing. So when I'm in Europe, the same thing, you know. Europe, depression is a big, big problem. Okay. Now, in my study, throughout the whole world, out of four people, one people are suffering from malnutrition. You know why? Because when I'm in Europe, out of four people, one people are depressed. Even a youngster, you know, at the age of 24, at the age of 25, they are taking this antidepressant. So many of the doctors come to see me. They say, Dr. Lim, how to treat depressants? I told them, the problem is not with the mind. The problem is with the body, the stomach. No, you have not enough food. You have not enough nutrition, okay? So that the body had to produce a nutrition, you stress the organs. When you stress the organs, the biochemical inside the body will not be balanced. When the biochemical in the body will not be balanced, your mind cannot be balanced. Okay, so that they do one experiment. Okay, the doctor give this depressed person a high dosage of spirulina. Okay, 20 spirulina, 30 spirulina per day. This thing. Then my next visit there, one of the patients come to see me. He said after taking spirulina, he has a sensation, a wake up sensation. Suddenly he find the world more colorful. Everything become better. We do not treat his mind. And why taking spirulina, he can have a good feeling. The thing is that we need trace nutrients. Okay, you see, in the history of medical history, first we understand the macronutrients. Or we understand carbohydrate, we understand protein, we understand fat. This is the first stage. Then we come for this micronutrients, like vitamins, like everything, you know. Then nowadays, we go to even this nano. We go to the nano level, we need traces of a nutrient. Our body is like engine. Okay, sometimes a big engine, because of one small screw is loosened, the whole engine is shaking or fail. This is the thing. So the same thing with health, okay? So the sure formula for a good health is that you must diversify your food, okay? You should eat as, not eat many food, you know? Eat many type of food, this thing. Many years ago, I went to Germany. It's a very sad case. One of my friends, he is a very strict organic eater, no? And the water he drink must from the mountains. Melting. He get the snow water. So I stay in his house for about 5 days. Okay. So I eat the same time, and he eat. He only buy the food from one organic shop. So I told him, this is not the way you to survive. You eat every type of food every day, the same type of every day. It's not good for your health. It's not good for your health. He do not believe me, and he died very young. This thing. So when I am in Australia, okay, many people have a very wrong concept about the food. Okay, they thought that they eat organic food, then they will be safe. No. You are not safe. So they talk so much about organic food, you know. So I one time I remember I go to Australia. I say, how many people are eating organic food? Please raise your hand. Almost everybody raise your hand. So my second question is, how many of you have very good health? Please raise your hand. Nobody raised their hand. Then I asked them, what's the point of eating organic food? Okay, is you want to have good health, but after eating the food, you still do not have good health? It defeats the purpose. So first thing first in food is organic food are good food. I do not go against the organic food. Okay, the message is that we need to diversify the food. Okay, so God give us everything, all the fruits, all the vegetable, different type of foods, okay? So as a human being, so we need to diversify the food. Now, certain food are very good in nutrient. First, of course, algae, spirulina, okay? Second category, of course, is a mushroom. You see, what's the difference between mushroom and a vegetable? Vegetable, normally, they can contain 10 to 20 type of active element, but every mushroom contains 300 to 400 type of active ingredient. You see? Then this fermented food. Fermented food, like this juice, everything, we ferment it with certain bacteria, everything. So these are the, and another category, this bean sprout. Okay, we support the brain. So these are the few categories that we try to promote to people so that we can have a health food. So in the future, I think we hope that we can have some MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, so we will train more scientists, this thing. So hopefully that we can promote this spirulina throughout India and eventually throughout the whole world. So thank you very much. Thank you.